you got it, then it's gone. Once it feels right, starts feeling wrong. Opposites, opposites, opposite. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Earn yourself some money, then you end up with receipts. Once you think you know it, you lose all your belief. Find yourself some sunshine, then you end up in the shade.
Need me to take my hand, 'cause what I can do.
already clear that you are mine, my dear. No one in this world's gonna take my place. If you need a doctor, my pet you will swallow. If you need a doctor, I will be back on your head to toe. If you want me to, then I can.
This next one is a jazz song that we wrote, and one of my favorite things that Gabe and I do is get together and just jam out on our jazz stuff, but we decided to actually write a jazz song, so here it is.
I slept alone last night, but you I want mine.
21. I'm not 21 anymore. I'm a little older than 21 now. Somewhere in there. But let's do it. And this is a song that we actually wrote for my last album, The Beautiful Awakening Project. And so, Novel, if you're watching, hi. I'm excited to see you. And hey, love, when I look into your eyes, Miss, oh, come here, lady. Miss Anna Slade. Woo! Woo! I'm gonna talk to you this while we stop it. Oh. Oh, everybody's getting get to see Gabe's backside right now.
That's good.
So Anna and I grew up together and literally have known each other since the day we were born. And a couple years ago, oh, where's this cord going? It's a little stuck. That's all right, I'm getting it. Just under the sofa. A few years back, I was living in the city and I was feeling a little bit overwhelmed trying to write and working on music, and the city was just crazy. And Anna, who lives in Denver, she came to visit me, and she saw that I was just like struggling to feel creative, and she was like, "Why don't you come to Denver, and we'll just like sit around the piano like we did when we were little, and we'll just play songs, and you can write songs, you can be creative." And so I went and spent one of the most magical creative seasons of my life with Anna and I writing together every day. And so this is one of the songs that we did together.
Give me a moment, love, while I collect myself. I spent
I'm gonna give you that. I think we're gonna take some questions. Is this the time?
This is the time.
All right, this is the time. I'm being told.
This is the time.
This is. Dun, dun, dun. It's question time. So you guys can ask me questions. I'd say you can ask me anything you want, but that's not true. You can't ask me anything. You can ask most things. I'm a fairly open book.
This is going way too fast right now.
It's going way too fast?
Way too fast. Album when?
Album when? Good. Good. Album when?
No question mark, just album when.
You know what? That's actually a really good question. We're in the studio right now. I'm recording all the way up until the end of the year. And then going out to LA, the beginning of next year. And can we confidently say 2014? I think that is a very...
I would confidently say like late summer, early fall.
Yeah, but we're planning for... Thank you. That's my manager talking, so... Good answer. Mm-hmm. All right. What else? Wow, it is so
literally
fast.
So, I can't even read right now.
No, it's really...
Seriously,
you guys are
like
amazing.
So fast. I can't even read them right now.
Hi.
You see this?
I do. Do you want me to play another song while you try to catch one?
No. I got it.
So it really is insane. Wow, hi guys.
So many. Oh, and your mouse doesn't go the right way.
Are you getting nauseous?
Yep, I am.
I feel extremely loved. So thank you for that.
Tour? Question mark?
Tour.
That's all I saw. I can see one word at a time.
Tour. Okay. I can tell you. On Monday, I'm going to be announcing a show that I'm going to be playing out in LA. I'm kind of focusing on obviously finishing the project. And then I'm actually going out to LA for pilot season now that I just finished acting school. I know. I have a friend here from school. Really glad you're here. Thank you. Yes, I will be announcing some shows here and there over here on the East Coast and West Coast. So keep your ears and eyes open for that. But yeah, tour, full on tour. That's still to come. I think I spilled it, maybe. Okay, what else we got?
I can't even. I literally. These are so fast.
You can't? Should I just talk about some
stuff? Take a photo of the screen.
Yes. I mean, you can take as many photos as you want. Do you see how fast that's going?
Yes.
You can't read that fast. No one can read that fast.
So I'll just give you a little update until we can catch a question. Thank you, Josh. So like I said, just after finishing acting school, I jumped right back in the studio and am just having so much fun. I think that, I get asked a lot, like, what have you been doing for the last several years? But the last few years have been just an incredible opportunity for me to explore and process and figure out what I want to do, and working with people like Gabe and other friends where I have that freedom to just play is amazing. So I'm having so much fun with it. And the acting actually really inspires it as well. When I'm like reading for different roles or studying different roles, that inspires a ton as well. Just kind of transitioning from a life that hasn't been fully 100% submerged in music, which has actually been so good because now I have things to talk about other than just music and life experiences other than just being in the music industry.
Yeah.
I'm hoping that this, I feel like people always say, this is gonna be my most personal record so far. This is the one that's like the truest to who I am. But I think I'll be able to communicate in a more personal way this time, just because I think I know myself a little bit better than when I was making records at 17.
I think that they want to know any favorite Beautiful Awakening song that you didn't get to sing tonight.
Oh my gosh. Beautiful Awakening. I think the song Wait on Beautiful Awakening, that was another song I did with Novel, actually. That will forever be one of my favorites. Actually, the only reason I didn't do that tonight is because I've been recovering from some vocal stuff, and although I love that song. I was worried it might be a little bit hard to sing tonight. That's the honest truth on that. Sorry, Nav. I know you wanted to probably hear Wade. Yeah.
Do you want any more?
I feel like you're gonna get nauseous trying to catch.
Yeah, I don't even think I'm caught up to the bottom right now.
Okay, if you see anything else pop up that's vital to answer.
Yeah.
Let me know.
I did see that someone wants to know if there's gonna be any hip hop collaborations.
Hip hop collaborations. That's a great idea. Maybe I should do a rap song. Maybe I should collaborate with myself. I am so inspired by so many genres of music that who knows who I'll end up working with. I love collaborating with people from different genres. As of right now, I don't have any, rap guest appearances or anything, but like in the past, when I've worked with Novel, he's a rapper, he's rapped on some stuff, I'm definitely not opposed to it. So, we'll see. No, no, no. Why, are you like submitting yourself? You got one?
Someone asked, what's the most challenging thing about writing songs?
Oh.
That's a good one.
Yeah, that's a great question, actually. I think the most challenging part is that when, for me, it's telling a really personal story and it's a very emotional process. And for me, it's once I'm actually inspired by something and I feel like I'm kind of in the zone, usually the songs come fairly quickly, but I think the hardest time to write is when you don't feel that inspiration and you really just have to show up and work and write anyway. If I'm not feeling really in touch with my emotion about something, it's hard for me to find the words. And so I feel like I've learned a lot in just kind of writing for this project and making it a little bit more of, I don't want to say a job because it's so fun, but treating it a little bit more like a job where you just have to show up and write regardless of if you're feeling it or not, if that makes sense. All right. Here's another new one. This is called I Will Rest, and sometimes when I can't fall asleep because my mind is racing a million miles a minute, this is how I feel. My mind starts to Okay, this is my dad being. When Dad would tuck me into bed and he would come and bring his guitar and he would sit and play me Beatles songs or what was the Dad and Savannah who sang that one?
Yeah.
Yeah, Lovin' Spoonful. Oh, yeah. Lovin' Spoonful. Lots of Lovin' Spoonful. Anyway, so I called him and was like, would you come to town for this show and come sing with me? And so we're gonna do a song that that he used to sing to me when I was little. I'm
really excited
that you're here.
What a day for a daydream. What a day for a daydreaming girl. I'm lost in a daydream. Dream about my pleasure and joy.
And even if time is really on my side, I'm blowing the day to take a walk in the sun. Follow my face on somebody's new mown lawn. I've been having a sweet dream.
Oh, yeah.
I've been dreaming since I woke up today. Starring me in my sweet dream. Cause she's the one that makes me feel this way. And even if time is passing me by, about the dues you say I got. Tomorrow I'll pay the dues for dropping my load.
Oh, yeah.
High in the face for being a sleepy bolto.
Everybody's got a whistle.
The time and I'm wasting it slowly.